my PlayStation 4. Matt Ryan. Come on, Matty Ice. All right, who's watching this? A whole lot of people. Injuries. Rock Thomas, of course, out for the season. Oh, Derrick Henry. He's questionable, so we're not going to see him, unfortunately.
Hi, everybody.
Hello, boys and girls. I am Flipper55 with Fat Finger Gaming, and welcome. Fat Finger Gaming's continuing coverage of 2015 college football season. Today, the Iron Bowl. Last time we were here, it was the kick six, bringing Auburn the win and the SEC West title. Well, they're looking for the win and the SEC West title again. Winner of this game does win the West. Winner of this game plays Georgia in the SEC title game. Winner of this game has a chance for the college football playoff.
Touchback. Well, from that first time they walked on.
Oh, Nick.
Here they are as seniors taking the field.
You look so menacing walking the sidelines. So here we go, the Iron Bowl. The best defense in the nation will take on an offense that hasn't been the best in the nation, that's for sure. There is Kenyon Drake, who gets stuffed, minus 2 yards. Alabama's had issues. Alabama's had a lot of issues this year. Everything from falling asleep there for a couple quarters against Wisconsin, and they couldn't come back in the Cowboys Classic, to weird calls in the SEC, weird calls in the Arkansas game that cost him a loss. Kenyon Drake right here falling for no apparent reason after 5 yards when he probably had a wide open down the sidelines run. By the way, look for O.J. Howard here. Coker, oh, or just a quick run there by Kenyon Drake, and he gets up the middle for the first down. BCS sounds, you talking about, BCS sounds better.
From their own 37-yard line.
BCS BCS semifinals?
Gives it off. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Not quite sure.
Picks up five with the carry. That makes it second and
BCS championship. See, the problem is if you say BCS championship, once again, you're talking about a single game. Are you talking about BCS playoffs? Is that what you is that what we want? I don't know. You do realize that I will probably be at the end of this game still talking about what actually sounds better. Kenyon Drake getting hit behind the line. Third and 10. This is not Alabama's bread and butter here. They don't have Amari Cooper anymore, so whatever. Oh, God, and that's what they're going to do. Jacob Coker right there. Sacked 5 yards back. And they will be punting on their first series. So Jeremy Johnson gets on out there.
As
long as they don't fumble this punt, which happens way too often.
And he's tackled at the 31-yard line.
There we go, Jeremy Johnson. He must have gotten hurt and whatever in the game against Idaho. Obviously, we did not play that on Fat Finger Gaming. We just let that one be an EA sim. Thank God it was an EA sim win because I didn't want to sit through that one. Jeremy Johnson going nowhere. Second and 12. Youch. And there is his lackluster passing.
From their own 29-yard line. Second down.
Hasn't, you know, he's only thrown 1,700 yards, 12 touchdowns, or 16 touchdowns. I think he's got 12 interceptions or something like that. There is Peyton Barber, and that dude has been a beast. The fact that Rob Thomas is out. Javon Robinson, the junior college transfer, comes in every now and then to give him a little breather. But without a doubt, it has been Peyton Barber, just the man. And look at that. He continues to be the man. He is going to carry the Tide on his back down the field right now. Once again, Peyton Barber. This time he doesn't even get touched till he's about 10 yards downfield.
Anytime a back has a year like this, it sure opens some eyes. And let me tell you, he's earned every one of those yards.
Oh, Peyton Barber this time gets tackled after 1 yard. So they're not going to let him get 10 yards downfield this time. They have decided the Iron Bowl is not going to be a Peyton Barber run fest. Well, they still don't know. It's only one play. Johnson throws first time. He finds Duke down inside the 15-yard line. Duke has had a horrible year. It's one of those things where had he just come out to the NFL last year, he probably would have done better. Has not positioned himself well after this. It's a lot is Jeremy Johnson's fault. Without a doubt, it's Jeremy Johnson's fault not getting him the ball. Jeremy Johnson has been much more of a running quarterback than a throwing quarterback, and we have actually seen that in real life. Louisville, he threw for 147 yards. We're talking about the real Chick-fil-A Classic. Five picks in two games. Two picks against J-State. You gotta seriously. This is funny. If you go back on YouTube and look at, there's Javon Robinson taking it in. Auburn gets up 7-0 on the Crimson Tide.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
And Miami Pitt did not get the upset, so we do not have an upset alert to have Miami have to play them. Although it would have been fun because Miami, of course, Pittsburgh upset Notre Dame, knocking them basically out of the college football playoffs. Then they turned around and hit Louisville, knocking them out of the ACC championship and the college football playoffs. So they've had some fun. And that right there is a EA construct. This is not a guy that's actually on Alabama. The dude's like a 6'7 wide receiver.
Loose football scooped up by the offense.
And they avoid horrible start to this one. Second and 16. We'll see if they can pick up. Oh, it's going to be forced third and nine.
This environment and that pass rush is a tough combination for any quarterback.
All right, third and 20, third and 19, who cares? I don't think the extra foot really matters right now. Coker throws! Oh! And he just can't hit Brown. Nice coverage there by Kaunas. And that's going to be fourth and 20, and then we're going to pause this, get to instant replay to bring back our overlays. Oh, that was a nice move there. So at least they will not be backed up. Had he gotten tackled where he stood, they definitely would have been backed up. All right, we got our overlays back. Auburn up 7-0. Has a chance to go to increase this lead. Oh my, Peyton Barber again. Oh, you know what? That's funny. I answered that when you said out of the Power 5 conference, who are your favorites? I thought you meant, like, if you took away all the Power 5 conferences, who's your favorite teams? That's funny. You meant, like, who do I root for in the Big Ten, ACC, all that fun stuff. Is that what you meant, Fossil? Yeah, that's what you meant. That's funny. That's too funny. Okay, let's go through this. ACC, obviously, no doubt, NC State. I'm an alum. That's who I root for. Big Ten is Penn State. I grew up in... Oh, and Alabama just going to turn this one around. Gets the ball inside the 35-yard line. And Jeremy Johnson with another interception. Jeez. Big Ten is Penn State. I grew up in Western New York. Had a lot of games that we went down to State College. So I've been in Beaver Stadium a lot. Big 12. Big 12 used to be – I used to root for Iowa State. And the reason why I used to root for Iowa State is because I loved their annoying 80s uniforms. Now that they gave up the 80s uniforms – probably Kansas State. I've got some ties out there to the athletic department, so I probably go with K-State. Big with a Big 12. Pac-12. Oh, does he get him? Pac-12. I'm gonna go with Arizona State. Arizona State, once again, annoyingly bright uniforms. Absolutely loved them back in the 80s. Do not like the alternative black uniforms, but I do like it when they get a little annoying. And not to mention both and Iowa State and K-State for that matter. No, Arizona and Iowa State. I've been in online dynasties with. And so, you know, when you take a team in online dynasties, you sometimes get a little bit of love for. And SEC is Kentucky, once again, because of the dynasties. And the unfortunate thing is, if Kentucky ever got really good in football, I would hate them. Because there's nothing worse than having a team that wins national championships in basketball and football, Florida. It drives me absolutely nuts. You should not. There should be a law somewhere in the NCAA in which you get like the death penalty if you win a national championship the same year in both football and basketball, Florida. You have to be cheating in order to do that, Florida. You really seriously need the death penalty if you do that, Florida. So yeah, I do root for Kentucky. The Kittens of Chaos. My Kittens of Chaos is what I call them, just because I want them to. Anytime they beat a big team, it just throws that division into complete chaos.
He's at the 30, tackle made at the 26.
And they're a lot of fun. Now the funny thing about when you said throw out all the Power Five, who's your favorite team? I pick Utah State. Funny thing about Utah State is I started rooting for them. And I'm trying to think. I think it was like NCAA Football 94 or something like that. Back in 94, I was looking for a team to run through a season with. And Utah State back then had the same exact U that the Hurricanes had on the side of their helmets. Only instead of, you know, the green, the orange, and the white, it was dark blue, white, and just drab-ish gray to white sort of thing. And what it reminded me of Bizarro. You know, Superman, and then you got Bizarro. And so it just reminded me of the Bizarro Miami, and I hated Miami. I still to this day hate Miami. The fun thing about Miami, though, I want them to do well because college football, to me, is less fun without the U being completely arrogant, crazy, number one, we're awesome. Yes, by the way, seeing that Fossil, yes, it is... It is chaos spelled with a C, because I initially went to write on YouTube the Kentucky Kittens of Chaos and spelled them, you know, spelled it with a K, and I looked at the capital letters and I thought, you know what, I'm not posting that. So the C is for chaos. The C is without a doubt in the chaos. We're not going to spell it K-A-O-S, because without a doubt, when you put in the K-O-A-S on any kind of comment in YouTube, stare at it for a little while, then realize, yeah, I probably shouldn't put that. However, it sort of does fit with that state. All right, I'm going to get in trouble for that one. Somebody's going to have something nasty to say about that.
And the result, 7 points. And the big plays that they had running the football were the keys to that drive.
All right, so the Iron Bowl, Auburn taking a 14-3 lead, looking good on offense, which is, I mean, it's what Auburn has actually done after the first couple games. They've actually started looking good on offense, and with the best defense in the nation, you are looking at a team. You are looking at a team that should definitely be in the college football playoffs, as long as, of course, they win this game and then win the SEC championship. And as we went on, as we started, okay, for some reason I can't play the Vikings San Francisco game. Maybe it hasn't started yet. Anyways, yeah, this is what I do. I get on Twitch, we do this, I talk, I do the Twitch chat, and I also watch Monday Night Football. A lot of fun. Got football all over the place. Oh, nice throw there to Brown. He's going to be out of the 32. Foster, sorry. I don't know why I think he's Brown. Where am I going with this? No idea. Just ran off into a tangent and left myself in the briar patch. Okay. Oh, so, yeah, Auburn. You got the...
And he just gets rid of it.
With the way things were going with Louisville winning, undefeated Miami, some of the things going on in the Big 12, I was really, really worried that the best, there would be like five teams either undefeated or with one loss up there in the top, and I wouldn't be able to, if Auburn won the SEC championship, I wouldn't be able to get it there in there. However, because things have fallen out nice for Auburn, if Auburn wins this and wins the SEC championship, I'll guarantee I put them in there. Bama, on the other hand, with three losses, would not be looking good. And there is no way that there's no way that Georgia is getting in here. With some of the offensive games that they've had, and you know that. Let's put it this way: that 10-7 game in Jacksonville against Florida. I mean, that's just no, not happen. I cannot allow that team to soil my college football playoff. There's a selection committee of one. And I will guarantee that selection committee of one will take the Bulldogs resume, rip it up into itty-bitty little pieces, and throw it out. I don't care if they beat Auburn. Which right now Alabama's trying to make sure that it is not a foregone conclusion that Auburn's going. Look for O.J. Howard, I'm telling you. It is a security blanket. What did I just tell you? That is definitely Coker's security blanket down anywhere. But especially down here in the red zone. And I really, 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 really would like. Yeah, it says it starts at 10:15, but I can't play the Vikings San Francisco game on my iPad.
Alabama is lining up to kick this one off.
I mean, not that I really want to watch the Nutcracker run.
Momentum swing,
but you know,
fairly even. And with so little separation,
still gonna be a fun game.
Can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Auburn holds a 4-point lead. They'll get him for a loss.
Peyton Barber getting hold of 0 yards. You gotta celebrate on that with the way Alabama's line has been ripped open. Now here's the thing. That is the biggest thing between real life and Fat Finger was the fact that.
And he tackles him hard.
Alabama on this tweaked roster, their lines aren't what they are in real life, and that's unfortunate. I don't even think Ohio State's is the way that way they are in real life. You know, it's just.
He gets out to about the 44-yard line.
I've played a bunch of dynasties. I've seen I've seen dominating O-lines. Unfortunately, just the way this the roster fell out, it just wasn't the dominating both offense and defensive lines that they really do have.
The defensive line with the run. The problem here was that the quarterback didn't sell the pass very well.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on their own 43.
Peyton Barber up the middle, rips that, just gashes Alabama again. Alabama just cannot stop Peyton Barber from finding holes and working his way 10 yards downfield before he even gets touched. At least they got to him in 5 yards downfield, but that's going to set up a second and six. And I think everybody likes a second and six. 4:20 left to go in the first half. Jeremy Johnson, you know, that doesn't help. Jeremy Johnson's had a rough enough time passing, but when you are going to drop a ball that he puts right in your hands, that's not nice. That's really not nice. Jeremy Johnson again, this time throws, and that is complete to Rico Suave.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel
and do not tell him I'm calling him that, because if he and I ever meet, he's definitely big enough that he will whoop me. I honestly have no idea how those boys in Sports Center, actually most of the time they're in Sports Center, they're nice about the nicknames, but you gotta wonder if there's a nickname that you just do not want to get out. You gotta be nervous meeting some of these guys. We had a guy on board the ship. I was in the Navy. We had a guy on board the ship. Dude had kidney stones. And real huge issue with kidney stones. And those things are painful. Nothing to joke about. Nothing to be mean about. But man, one day, for no apparent reason, I called the dude Pebbles. And I feel really, 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 really bad for doing it. And unfortunately, he wasn't big enough to whoop my butt. Otherwise, he should have. He definitely should have. But I got, you know, I was just in one of those moods and told him to shut up, Pebbles. And that nickname stuck the rest of the time he was on board the ship. And boy, did I feel bad.
Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out in the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time? The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
All right, so Kenyon Drake trying to get moving here. That makes it second and eight. And the ground game really does. You've got to get the ground game started. You do have to get the ground game started here. I've made sure that with the way I do these simulations that the ground game is consistent. So if you got a good ground game, it's consistent. You can have a consistently good offense. Whereas the passing game, like, is explosive, and if you start clicking on, you know, with a passing game, you can whoop some people. Texas A&M, you know, definitely. Oh God! Our resident Alabama guy just put something on chat. Of an unfortunate name, a last name of a dude. I would have to say I would legally, I don't know. Actually, me, I wouldn't change it. I would so live that. It would be, I tell you what, that would be, honestly, I mean, I was the quarterback on our high school team. I would love for that to have been on the back of my jersey and had to listen to the announcers say, and whack off throws. Oh, God. I would live that up. I would have way too much fun with that. But normally, those bad last names, from what I've seen, the bad last names are always the smaller dudes. You know, the dudes who already get picked on by, you know, appearance and stature and stuff. Which is unfortunate, too, because, you know, a big dude with a name like that, or like some dude like me who doesn't really care what you got, you know, what people think, and if you want to get in a fight over it, all right, fine, whatever, let's do it. The big dudes need those kind of names, because at least the humor will be fun to them. It's just crazy. cruel when it's on, you know, little guys. Unless, of course, the little guys do know kung fu, which I have seen before, and it was absolutely hysterical. First time I've ever seen a true roundhouse kick was from a dude who was about 5'4", and so and a bigger dude thought he could, you know, was all over him. I saw like a roundhouse kick to the jaw. I'm telling you right now, I've seen many of movies. It does it no justice until you actually see it in person and can hear that whack on the side of the dude's jaw. Dude deserved it. But anyways, in person is much, much better. Throw the he's got it. Chris Black. Yeah, it's Black, not brown, you dumbass. Oops, sorry about that. I knew it was a color.
Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
The slogan is Virginia is for lovers. Not much loving going on between the Cavaliers and the Hokies in the battle for the Commonwealth Cup. Check out these two teams keeping it close.
Scott, 15, as his kick team line.
All right, Alabama keeping it in there, down by four.
Plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchdown.
Now we need to keep it around a field goal because we need a field goal at the last second here by Alabama. I mean, obviously, the last time we were here was the fun old kick six. This thing's got to come down to the last second field goal. It has to. Alabama has to wheel out their field goal unit here in the last second. Finally, Jeremy Johnson gets somebody to catch the damn ball.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and
6 for 10, 64 yards, and we are a minute away from the second half. This has definitely been classic Jeremy Johnson throughout the year. But as I said, he got his act together here the last bunch of games, and that's the reason why Auburn looks so good. Come on, baby. Boom. Peyton Barber can't get anywhere. 59 seconds left to go. One timeout. Plenty of time to get the ball down the field to at least kick a field goal and be up by seven. If you look for Duke, on the other hand, I mean, you got time to get into the end zone, especially since it's going to stop after every first down, as long as Jeremy Johnson doesn't get taken down trying to run the ball. Tick, 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 tick.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signal straight.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Once and all, going deep. Touchdown, Tigers.
And there's Jeremy Johnson right there hooking up.
The wide receiver flew down the field on that
touchdown. Oh, and Duke. And we now have a 28-17 ball game, 38 seconds left to go in the half.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
We got to keep this thing close, guys.
He'll return it from the one. He's taken down at the 19.
A resident Auburn fan, on the other hand, obviously enjoying it. Oh, look, I can finally start playing the Vikings-San Francisco game. I'm doing Twitch broadcast. Yay me. What the hell is San Francisco wearing? All right, 30 seconds left to go. Two timeouts. Can Alabama at least get in field goal range so they can get it returned for a touchdown?
It's first and 10. Ball on the 31.
Coker, drop it back. Going to get, thought he was going to get blasted. But Casanova does get his man, takes him down right there. Got to waste another timeout, and they didn't get very far. By the way, if you guys aren't seeing the Monday night game, San Francisco is wearing all black uniforms. which I'm just not happy about.
Boy, the defender was just sitting back there waiting to make that big
hit. That's just wrong. San Francisco in all black uniforms is wrong. Sorry. I don't know if it's some kind of homage to some old jersey that they used to wear, which I do not think so. I think even the 60s they wore some kind of red. When they were in a different league, I think about it. I think that's where they started.
He gets it away. This is a really nice punt.
Anyways, they weren't in the AFL. They were like All-American League or something like that. I swear. Not the actual American Football League, but I swear they're in the same league that Cleveland and Detroit were in, and I can't remember what that league was called.
I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. 28-17.
All right, boys and girls, 28-17. The Iron Bowl, we are at halftime. For the love of God.
Welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
Let's get this thing closed in. We need Auburn to turn the ball over. We need Jeremy Johnson for another interception. Yes, I'm not rooting against Auburn. I'm just rooting for a close game here. I'm telling you, I want them to wheel out the kicking unit.
Tackled at the 25.
Peyton Barber. Basically, I guess it's going to be Peyton Barber is either going to be hit for zero or 12-yard gain. Anywhere in between, probably not. Jeremy Johnson. Oh, 6 yards. Third and four. Come on, guys. Johnson throw. Nice catch there by Rico Suave. Very nice. Converts on that third down and keeps Auburn with the ball. Alabama does not need any more points to be scored until they can answer back. I can tell you that right now.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. That'll make it second and four.
So what do we got going on here week three? What kind of fun? Week three, we're not, LSU Auburn's next week, correct? That's not this week. I don't think. I think Kentucky, South Carolina is this week. No, I'm sorry. It was last week. That wasn't who I was thinking about. Kentucky, Florida is who I was about to say. What am I looking up? LSU. There you go.
Hand off, and he's met immediately.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Yeah, 19th. It is Auburn. All right.
Strike to his receiver. No good. Line it up again on third down. Here comes the pressure. Fires it out. Runs through a defender and he's in.
And there's Duke with a catch. It's going to be 35-17. This poor, poor Iron Bowl that may not live up to what I want the hype to be. A resident Auburn fan is probably sitting back there smiling and relaxing. Winner of this, I can't say it enough, goes on to play the SEC Championship, and the SEC Champion, if it's Auburn, will be in that Final Four. Of course, I can't say Final Four because that's trademarked. And I will be sued for every piece of revenue I bring to Twitch. Notice I didn't say how every piece of revenue I bring to myself. This is where our world is heading towards. You know, Twitch does do advertisement in front of my channel. You know, obviously, if you get on there, I don't get any of it, just, you know, yet, which is fine. I don't have I don't have the following that Nikki T has, so I don't. It's not really that big of a deal. However, you wait. Somebody's going to get in trouble for some kind of copyright stuff, and they're going to go right to. They're not going to sue Twitch. They will sue the little guy.
They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down.
Come on, Bama. I know you're better than that. Kenyon Drake's much better than that. Look, there you go. Oh, God. Swallowed up by Lawson. Oh, my. Youch. I love. I tell you what. I wish. I wish that any one of my teams. Actually, obviously the Buffalo Bills have got that great defensive line, but I wish that my NC State Wolfpack, or for that matter Penn State, I wish one of those dudes could field a defensive line like Auburn has, like Alabama typically has. So much fun. It changes the game so much.
About this linebacker over the years, it separates him from the rest are his instincts and ability to make the play. That's a nice.
That'd just be way too much fun. I would love to watch my Wolfpack actually be able to dominate through a season. Just it would be so great. You know, normally if we get good seasons, it's because, you know, we got Phillip Rivers and we can throw the ball around. We can just outmaneuver you. But to be able just to line up and say, dude, we're moving forward. Try to stop us, or on the opposite side of the ball. Yeah, dude, you ain't moving this. That'd be so great. You Auburn, Alabama fans should be just thanking the stars instead of complaining when you guys don't win a national championship. That's mostly towards the Alabama guys, by the way. You guys have no idea what it's like to watch week in, week out, just pray for victory. There's Jeremy Johnson going to take it up 35. We might be looking at a very, very quick iron ball. And then what's our third game? The Suck Eggs Bowl. So not only is it the Suck Eggs Bowl, it's the Suck Eggs Bowl without Chad Kelly because he got hurt in the Arkansas game.
Gets out to about the 44-yard line. That's a gain
of 8 on the play. Talking about a ratings downer.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Chad Kelly, when he got hurt, that was definitely one of that to me was a huge blow. I mean, he was great in this. It'd be like Ricky Seals-Jones getting hurt. This season would have broken my heart. It sucks when your standout guys get hurt, especially if they're on somebody like Ole Miss, where that's the only thing you got. Which obviously is not the only thing they got, because they did beat LSU. Teddy Bridgewater guns one into the stands. But he was under pressure. I mean, it wasn't like it was a bad pass. Oh, no. No, it was a bad pass. He actually had time to throw it. Oh, well. I was giving him the benefit of the doubt. Sure enough, he just gunned it up into the stands for no apparent reason. He had the guy on the sidelines. It would have been a good catch. There's Javon Robinson taking it down to the 31-yard line. So this Iron Bowl, I don't know. We're cutting down to the fourth quarter. I'm losing hope here. I am definitely losing hope. I would truly doubt if the real Iron Bowl is going to be... Well, actually, I'm not going to say that because... If Auburn comes out and creates early, in real life, Alabama might have some issues. Oh, tense and stiff arms. One breaks another. 42-17. I don't see Alabama as a comeback type of team this year.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
He'll take it from the but we'll see. We're obviously early in the season. We'll see what happens with the real college football season.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down and they're forced to punt.
And think, you know what? The Oregon-Michigan State game. I was disappointed in the fact that you could tell Vernon Adams. You could tell he was having issues throwing the ball because of that index finger. And that really did – that cost Vernon Adams, like, a good national look. He is a good quarterback. He's a good all-around quarterback. Good athlete all-around. You know, he's definitely the kind of guy you want running that Oregon offense. But you know, because of that index finger, the throws were just not coming out crisp. He looked to me what was going on. He looked a lot like a typical high school quarterback in which, you know, the ball just does not come out crisp. They sort of have a bad mechanic with the ball coming out. And that was, I've seen him play before and that was the index finger. He changed his release.
He made a great read and delivered a very
He changed his release due to his index finger wasn't getting a lot of oomph behind the ball. And that was unfortunate because I really was looking forward to seeing the kid on the national stage. This is a great game overall. I wanted Vernon Adams to have just a great game. And he and Connor Cook just put up some great numbers and everybody talking about how great of a game that was. Instead of talking about interceptions here, you know, late interceptions, bad throws here and there.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 27.
Third and 28, folks. Sure, why not? Just chuck it.
Here comes the pressure.
Just chuck it. There you go. All right, that's not really what I meant. You want to throw it to the dude in the red helmets with the white jerseys? You could have chucked it into the end zone and it would have been better because at least it would have been a touchback had they intercepted it.
And down he goes, the 39-yard line.
Oh, so Alabama. Hold it, timeout. Oh, yeah. Oh boy! So Alabama's going to turn in a very disappointing season, 8-4,
the Tigers with a huge lead,
including thumping by Auburn. And the resident Alabama and Auburn guys would know this. Was it back in? It was Nick Saban's first. It was Nick Saban's first year that Auburn thumped Alabama. I can't think of a time. Where this game got too out of hand with Auburn winning. I can remember a game in which the game almost got out of hand, and then there was a huge second half comeback, but that's besides the point. What was it, 28-0 at one point before the comeback?
Throw. He's at the
little reception there by Javon Robinson. So, suck eggs bowl after this.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 28.
7 minutes left to go. Looking for some filler. Another drop. Jeremy Johnson, 4 TDs. Less than 200 yards in 4 TDs. I don't know exactly how you do that. But sure.
Deep pass to the end zone.
Yeah, that ain't happening. They went for it on fourth down. Why? Because Auburn hates Alabama just that much. You know, 42-17 was just... wasn't enough.
Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. And they make the stop at the 44. That last catch gives him 100 yards receiving.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw
him
the
ball. Myron Johnson, the good old EA construct.
Shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver.
Like the Megatron. As you can see, I don't know if you guys can clearly see that. That dude is 6'7". Dude is huge. Too funny. I love those EA constructs. 6'7". Dude can move. I mean, it's like Super Megatron out there.
From the 44-yard line. Second down.
Alabama should have a decent dynasty. LSU is expected to win the West next year. Alabama is supposed to come in second. Auburn third. I think that's the way it's supposed to go. Auburn's actually supposed to like just start diving into nothingness, which is typical of NCAA games. Auburn doesn't normally... Auburn doesn't win the recruiting battles against Alabama and LSU. It's like, and LSU for some reason just dominates the recruiting game. So I mean, LSU winds up most years LSU winds up being that dominant force in the SEC West.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
They'll bring him down at about the 3-yard line. That'll make it second and inch. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Can Bama get it in? Got this thing to 3 touchdowns.
Touchdown.
There we go. Golf clap, everyone. Golf clap.
For the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
He makes the PAT. So an 8-play, 66-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
And we're going to try an onside kick. He gets. You really want... You really want to get blown out. You really, 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 really do.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
And there's Jeremy Johnson. He's like, we're rolling up 50 on Tide.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line.
This is our house.
We'll get to see the backup quarterback here.
No. Uh-oh. Really? Oh, boy. Jeremy Johnson just got hurt. Oh, boy. So we are going to we'll let a little time run down here. John Robinson a little shaken up. We were going to let a little time run down here just to see if it'll show up. Hopefully Jeremy Johnson's just done for the day.
Makes it to the 11.
Now I realize that Jeremy Johnson doesn't do a great job throwing the ball, but he does do a great job with his legs. He can move the ball with his legs. And that obviously that quarterback read with Peyton Barber and Jeremy Johnson is just amazing. And the quarterback read with Sean White and Peyton Barber is less than amazing. I'm really getting annoyed by the San Francisco 49ers black uniforms. Really, seriously.
He's in trouble. He's got it. Touchdown.
Sean White can throw, though, I guess. I feel like it's a... I just feel like it's a slap in the face to 49er faithful. I don't know.
It's a 6-play, 43-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Like everything that made the 49ers great. Bruised ribs, 2 quarters. All right, so Jeremy Johnson is done for this game. Thank God. He won't get hurt anymore. But he will be back for the SEC championship.
Don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays.
Oh, Coker gets hit while throwing the ball.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their passing.
And of course, they're showing they're showing when they show the interviews with the players, they're showing them in red jerseys.
From their own 27-yard line, it's second down.
I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. I'm writing a letter to my congressman in the NFL. Which, by the way, my father is hysterical. If... What the hell are you doing, Teddy? If anything ticks off my father has written more senators and congressmen now that the dude's retired than probably the President of the United States. I'm telling you. There's a squirrel on his lawn. I guarantee somebody's getting a letter. Some senator, some kind of squirrel control laws. I'm telling you, seriously. It's hysterical. Dude's retired and can do nothing but send letters out to senators. Congressmen, representatives, those guys, all of them. They all get it. One of these days, the FBI is going to come to his house. Be like, dude, you're done. Oh, we got another pick. I think that's... Is that Casanova? No, it's not Casanova. That's Whitehead. Jeremy Whitehead has been a great free safety for Auburn. This Auburn team, you got the big dudes. You got Presidente. You've got... Lawson, you've got, who's number one? The big number one dude. I always forget his name, because I want to call him president. Anyways, you got him. Then you look at the cornerbacks. You got Jonathan Jones. You have Countess on the other side. Your safety, Whitehead. Oh, you've got such great talent on this defense. This is in the digital world and in the real world. I think I might have some college eligibility left. Let me go into Auburn. I can quarterback the damn people. We are running down the clock here, thank God.
Well, a nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but this game, quite frankly, has been over.
This is unfortunate. I'm ready for it to end. So our primetime Iron Bowl.
Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to.
I didn't think Alabama was gonna have this. It was gonna have a chance. Like I said, the digital Alabama is not even close to the real Alabama. So this is the way we're going to... This is the way it ends. Oh, I thought that thing was going to back up on the one-yard line. Get one more shot at them.
They've been bringing the heat, and they've gotten to them on several occasions. This defense has had success getting after the quarterback.
They also have gotten them to turn it over twice.
This offense's best bet...
All right, so 45 seconds. What is Alabama going to do?
So maybe they should just focus...
Throw another interception? We'll see.
Keep the defense guessing.
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. Alabama will take a
timeout. No, don't call a timeout. Come on, guys. Come on. Let's get to the suck eggs game. Come on.
Ball on the 22. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. And he's tackled right around the 32.
Another timeout. Oh, there's Brown. So they got timeout of the half. Black was the dude that I was thinking of. I did not know that they had a Brown on their team as well. I don't think they do. That's got to be an EA construct. I mean, do they seriously have a Black and a Brown on their team?
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 32-yard line.
All right, man, you have a good night there, guy.
Under pressure. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play. Down,
Let's go. He gets sacked on the play.
Just let the con. Just let it run out. Let it run out. Please let it run out. Oh God, I'm trying to look up a website, and of course I get this big iced tea ad in my face.
The sack makes this a fourth and very low.
All right, this website does not have a Brown anywhere on their depth chart. It's got to be a construct. I don't remember. I don't remember Brown being on their team. Not that I know everything about Alabama.
Well, late in the fourth quarter, this game has been over for a long time, and now we just want to get out of here like these.
But this, then again, that website has been the one that I've been using, and it's been off, and so that's part of the reason why my rosters are off. Part of the reason why they're off is because some of the decisions I had to make. Of course, I guessed wrong. If you've ever heard the term 50-50-90. It's normally talked about engineers with the fact that if you give somebody like an engineer a 50-50 shot, you know, true, false, whatever it is, you get a 50-50 shot to get the right answer, 90% of the time they will be wrong.
The loser in this one will have this date marked in red on their calendar for next year.
Try our nice tea. Here you go. All right, let's get the stats, and we'll move on to the Suck Eggs Bowl. Unfortunately, God, I really wish that game would have been good, would have been better. Because I'll tell you right now, Auburn, Georgia, that SEC championship will be horrible. I mean, we've already seen in regular season, and it wasn't as bad, like it wasn't as bad of a blowout as it could have been. And I think this time around, the nice confines of an indoor arena, I think Auburn probably gonna put up 50 on them, and Georgia would be lucky if they score 17. And the SEC West will take away their seventh straight victory in the SEC championship game. Oh, that's gotta burn somebody's butt. Jeremy Johnson, under 200 yards, 4 TDs. I still don't know how exactly you do that, but okay. Duke with 5 catches, 100 yards, 2 touchdowns. It's probably the best I've seen a performance by Duke.